Greg Doucette is probably my favorite person that I watch in fitness on YouTube. The dude just yells at his camera, bangs on the table. It's like I can feel the spit from his mouth hitting my face while he's talking. Apparently, a lot of his viewers were bothering him to talk about the carnivore diet. He starts off with saying, "I'm not a registered dietitian, but I'm also not a registered moron. The carnivore diet is stupid." The word stupid being very prevalent in this video. And Greg does understand that the carnivore diet is supposed to be any animal-based food, whether it's meat, fish, or dairy. A comparison is made to the keto diet, saying you only eat protein and fat, not getting carbohydrates. This leads to him claiming that the carnivore diet is a new way to make money. People get bored of keto, end up going carnivore. That's the new play, and I think Greg is absolutely right. A lot of people have invaded the carnivore space to make money, which is much more evident recently, but it's safe to say that wasn't the case before 2017. Greg falls into conventional wisdom, what everyone's led to believe, modern dietary culture, saying that cutting out food groups isn't healthy, to eat your fruits and veggies, that it's not healthy, but there are very few people in general, let alone on YouTube, that know what healthy is, the basis of health. Greg starts talking about micronutrients, following a balanced diet, but we know he truly doesn't understand the importance of micronutrients. It's taken for granted that micronutrients come from fruits and vegetables, and Greg, as well as just about every other person, hasn't done their research here. The next point Greg brings up is that the carnivore diet works because it helps people lose weight, that any elimination diet helps people lose weight, but this isn't really true, as the carnivore diet is not as much of a weight loss diet as the ketogenic diet, and many people actually have an issue due to the estrogenic effects of conventionally raised meat, gaining weight in the short term as a result of going on the carnivore diet. And this is the inherent problem of said carnivore diet. The importance of vitamins, minerals, elements, and fatty acids that are only contained in quality animal foods is certainly not part of the general message. Opting for a much simpler, just eat meat. If popular carnivores actually wanted to make people healthy, they couldn't make as much money selling people cheap, shitty beef products, as people would start to question the quality of their food if they understood the importance of nutrients. But Greg Doucette is hilarious. He starts talking about the Superman diet being strawberry soup and steak, the Batman diet being beets and berries eaten before bed and breakfast, saying that the carnivore diet is just stupid and that we should eat healthy and exercise. We know what's shit, we know what's not shit, but I disagree with this. We, as the general population, doesn't really have a clue, including Greg. He does mention carnivore being an elimination diet, but the reason the diet works is because people are stupid and that the carnivore diet is simple. What Greg doesn't understand is the nutrient density of animal foods and that a lot of modern foods we consume have unnatural levels of palatability. Greg insists we have disordered eating because we are conditioned to eat in certain social conditions at certain times of the day, and he's absolutely right, but nutrient deficiencies and palatabilities address this disordered eating. People aren't satiating their appetite because they do not have the nutrients their body is craving, particularly from animal foods. One of Greg's major focuses is that we are eating too much shit, cookies, cake, ice cream, stuffing our faces, but if people had nutrients present in their diet from animal foods, they wouldn't be craving and stuffing their faces with this shit. Putting the fork down apparently isn't working for most people, but Greg insists that people know what's good for them and know what's bad for them. If that was the case, they wouldn't be asking him about the carnivore diet. Said person is likely having health problems or difficulty adhering to this conventional wisdom, what everyone accepts as correct. And this type of closed-mindedness is why America is so unhealthy. It's essentially an appeal to authority, especially him starting the video with, "I'm not a dietitian." if he understood what constitutes being a registered dietitian, he would never say something like that, because giving respect to a dietitian, to the food pyramid, to that educational system that has respect, is nothing short of comical. Circling back to money, Greg says that the reason the carnivore diet became so popular is because people want to make money. Everyone wants to look good, and the carnivore diet is the new thing catching on. As much as I would like to say that not everyone trying to make money has bad intentions, every major person I've observed in this carnivore movement has been trying to make money. I was making YouTube videos for years before making a penny, and now people are popping up out of the woodworks that are all sponsored by ButcherBox before their first video, before their first social media post. It's hard for me to speak positively about the carnivore diet in the context that Greg is referring to, because he's right. He might be missing some very important points on nutrient density and that true health requires quality animal foods, but technically the carnivore diet is just eating meat, and the discrepancy between a grain-fed steak diet and a high-quality nutrient-dense diet has not been made yet, despite me trying to spread this message for well over 2 years, because there's so much resistance against it for the reason of special interest groups. Greg makes a reference to losing water weight on low carbohydrate diets, and this is true to some degree, but modern carbohydrates are so inflammatory that it is a combination of that water weight and inflammation causing the drastic weight shifts when yo-yo dieting. He isn't aware of the weight gaining problems some carnivores had with highly estrogenic grain-fed meats. I think if Greg knew about that, he would have teared this diet a new one. As much as I like Greg, he is a bit of a downer, really appealing to authority, as we said earlier, discrediting any diet he doesn't follow for simple, fairly uncredited reasons. Whether it's keto or intermittent fasting, referring to them as quick fixes, but the carnivore diet is unique in a sense that it's a diet that is close to what makes humans healthy, the natural human diet. Paleo could have accomplished this, but I think the message of the paleo diet was also compromised by special interest funding, trying to sell crappy products. How many moms had paleo baking blogs using 40 ingredients in each recipe? To my understanding, Greg follows a standard American diet with some protein added in. Since he is an IFBB pro bodybuilder, we know the amount of performance-enhancing drugs being used can certainly skew his perception of diet. He hasn't been in the position of these people himself because of his drug use, but I would be curious to see what diets he is writing for people. You know, it's not to be said that he doesn't understand diet, but from the closed-mindedness we're seeing, the lack of objective thinking, it's possible. Greg's ultimate solution is not to have food around. And like many other things, I agree with what he's saying. Most people need to remove negative foods from their household in order to not be tempted to eat them. It's just unfortunate that so few people know about the bioavailability differences of micronutrients between animal and plant foods. They think all nutrients, vitamins, minerals, elements, and fatty acids can be obtained by eating your fruits and veggies and taking a multivitamin or fish oil pill. Telling people to exercise and eat healthy isn't working when every single person in the gym not on drugs looks like a walking corpse. And those people that do look like a walking corpse are just using a different type of drug. The message I am getting from this whole thing is that hunger signals are distorted because of modern foods in the standard American diet. We are in caloric excess, spiking our blood sugar all day, making ourselves sick, but starving our bodies of micronutrients. Limiting calories, as Greg advocates, might solve some superficial issues you're having, such as excess body fat, but it will never make you healthy. Even a low-quality carnivore diet will likely replenish certain vitamins and minerals that most people are deficient in. As we said, this diet is not a fad because it's as close as we have ever seen to the diet that is ideal for human health. That is what people are missing. Thank you guys for joining me. If you could please like the video, subscribe, hit that bell icon, share the video if you can. If you guys would like to support me further, check out Frankie's Free Range Meat, High quality, nutrient dense animal foods at an affordable price. Go to frankiesfreerangemeat.com. You can also check out Frankie's Naturals, minimal ingredients, minimally processed hygiene and cosmetic products. Thank you for joining me today, guys, and enjoy the rest of your day.